guys, welcome back to the fifth episode of Gossipy Mondays. I am Mansi and today I am going to compare the Harry Potter books with its movies. Now, if you are someone who haven't read the books or seen the movies, then I must warn you that there are going to be some spoilers. So, let's begin. See, I have read the books of Harry Potter first and then I have seen the movies. Then, I couldn't help but I was pissed about why certain things were not in the movies. Well, there are total 7 books in the Harry Potter series. The first one is the Philosopher's Stone. Then the second one is the Chamber of Secrets. Then there is the Prisoner of Azkaban. After that, there is this fourth part, that is the Goblet of Fire. Then the fifth part is the Order of the Phoenix. And sixth part is, the Half-Blood Prince. And finally, the seventh part, that is the Deadly Hallows. But in the movies, all these books are divided into total 8 movies, dividing the seventh book, that is the Deadly Hallows, into 2 parts, part 1 and part 2. I don't know if you guys know about it or not, but there is one more book in the Harry Potter series, that is Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. It is not by J.K. Rowling, but is in continuation in the seventh book by J.K. Rowling, that is the Deadly Hallows. In the Deadly Hallows, there is an end scene where Harry, Ginny, Hermione, Ron, Draco, they all send their children to Hogwarts, and then in Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, the story continues from there. So, I have read that too, and that was an okay-ish book. I'll review it some other time. So, I am just crazy about Harry Potter. And I couldn't help but notice so many differences, so many things that were important and I think should have been in the movies. And I'm going to share some of them over here with you guys. The first difference was in the book Goblet of Fire, when the Triwizard Tournament was taking place and Harry and Cedric, Victor Crumb and Fleur was in that maze. Over there in the book, they meet a Sphinx. But in the movies, there is no such thing. There are only magical bushes which are chasing all 4 of them. The second difference which I noticed was that certain characters such as Charles Weasley, Peeves, Ludo Bagman, etc. were in the book with active roles, but in the movies, they were either omitted or mentioned just once or twice. The third difference was in the last part of the Harry Potter series, that is the Deadly Hallows, where Harry uses the Elder Wand which he gets to repair his own wand, and then he returns the Elder Wand to the grave of Dumbledore. But in the movies, he actually breaks the wand in 2 parts and throws it up. The next thing which I noticed was about Dobby and Creature, that is the house elves. Though they were mistreated, but then too they played a vital role in the books. But in the movies, their roles were not that important. In fact, some of their roles and scenes were actually cut in the movies. The next thing which came to my notice was regarding the house points and the classes at Hogwarts. Like in the book, the mention of house points was there in almost every book, and they attended many classes and variety of classes multiple times in the books. But in the movies, house points were only there, in the first part, and they didn't attend much classes in the book. The next difference was in the fourth part, that is the Goblet of Fire. In the book, during the Triwizard Tournament for a competition, Dobby gives Gillyweed to Harry Potter, whereas in the movies, it was given to Harry Potter by Neville. Then, in the last part, that is the Deadly Hallows, in the book, Voldemort dies like a normal human being, whereas in the movies, he turns through dust. It was an unnatural death, and I must say it was kind of overdramatic. Then, there was this character of Victor Crumb. Like in the book, he's shown as a shy and intelligent person, but in the movies, he's shown as a stereotypical jock. The next difference which I noticed was actually not even required. Like in the book, the burrow where the Weasleys lived was safe and sound. But in the movies, it was burnt for literally no reason. Like it was not even required. The next thing happened in the Goblet of Fire. in the book, Harry and Voldemort's wands connected to each other as they both had the same phoenix feather in their wand. I understand that, but that only happened once in the books. But in the movies, in the last part that is the Deadly Hallows, it happened again. And you know, it is not possible because at that time both of them were using someone else's wand. So that is actually not logical, not possible. The next is, Hermione was seen using magic outside the school premises many a times, but she wasn't punished or warned at all. But in the books, nothing of this sort happened. Then again, in the last part, that is Deadly Hallows Part 2, Bellatrix was cursed Avada Kedavra and she turns to dust in the movies. Whereas in the books, people never turned to dust when they were cursed Avada Kedavra. Then there was this thing, like in the books, it is explained thoroughly what an animagus is, but in the movies, no such explanation was given, only Hermione just explained it in a sentence once in a movie. There were some small details too, such as certain dialogues or the person speaking them were changed, certain scenes were altered, and like you know, the small details like Harry, the color of Harry's eyes, the color of Hermione's dress, etc. These are the small details which were different in book and movies, and I think that could be kept in mind while they were making these movies. Look, I know all the details cannot be included in the movies, but being a Potterhead, I cannot help but I disliked the movies because of these changes. Do you also feel the same way? Are there any other differences which bothered you guys? If yes, then do mention them in the comment sections below and also share what was the best part about the books or the movies for you in the comment section. Alright guys, that's all for today. I hope you like this video. If you do, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel Books Gossip. Press the bell icon so that you won't miss any of my videos. Don't forget, I come up with new videos on every Mondays. You could also follow me on Instagram. My Instagram username is right here on the screen. I post many book aesthetics and fun reels over there that would interest you guys. Until then, keep reading. Bye!